Well, good afternoon. This is Pastor Barga. We're in the Gospel of Mark. And it's talking about who is going to be the greatest. What a subject. It starts out here in verse 34. It says, "But they held their peace, for by the way they had disputed among themselves, who should be the greatest?" Huh. Yeah. "And he sat down and called the 12 and saith unto them, If any man desire to be first, the same shall be last of all and the servant of all." Well, here's what the Word of God has to say about greatness. We certainly have it all mixed up, don't we? We don't understand at all what true greatness is. We strive to be first. We try to puff ourselves up. We try to make ourselves look good. And true greatness is our Lord Jesus Christ, the humble one, the one that sought no glory, sought no fame. And yet we, in America especially, and sad to say even in Christianity, seek greatness. We seek to tell who we are and what we've done, and most of the time try to make more of ourselves than we really are. True greatness is humility. Dear one, you might be out there, a lot of people that this is sent to on Facebook and through YouTube and the internet are unsaved people. A lot of unsaved people watch this, and they have the false thought that, and some of them are what the world would call great people. There's some people that watch this that are quite significant and have accomplished much as this world has to offer. But the truth of the matter is, true greatness comes through humility. There isn't anyone there's no one that can be saved coming with their accolades or who they are. It doesn't mean a thing of who we are socially or financially or politically or whatever the case may be. The only ones that are recognized of God and are honored of God and are saved are those that humble themselves and be like a child. True greatness, the Bible teaches, is humility. Humble yourself under the mighty hand of God, and he will exalt you. The last shall be first, and the first shall be last. So here it is in 34 and 35 of Mark 9. And I encourage you to read the whole chapter. But what is true greatness? And we've missed it. We're trying to fool ourselves with unimportant success that we have. And the only thing that's going to matter for eternity is what you've done with Jesus Christ. If you acknowledge the Savior, if you've taken Him to be your personal Savior, and then in the humility, in the footsteps of Christ, we can be great for Him, reaching others. I get so sick of hearing, and I've even noticed so much lately that with Christians, that it's all about them. They talk about their self. It's all about their self. It's all about who they are and what they have and what they do, and how vain, how foolish, how silly. The life of a Christian, a humble life of a Christian, is living for others, not all wrapped up in their self. So, listen, who's great? The servant, the humble one. And I hope you get that today. And if you've never really humbled yourself under the mighty hand of God and seen the need to repent, and the Holy Spirit, if God's working through this little preaching deal here today, if God's working with you, and if he's speaking to your heart, he's showing you that you don't have a good heart. You need to be saved. And you could repent and be saved today. Greatness in the eyes of God, taking the example of a child, taking the example of the Lord Jesus Christ, taking the example of Bible heroes. There's not a Bible hero we have that wasn't a humble servant. So, dear one, I hope that you would acknowledge Christ, that you would humble yourself under his mighty hand, and understand what true greatness is. It's being last, not first. It's not exalting ourselves, but exalting and glorifying God through the person of Jesus Christ. If you've never been saved, if God's speaking to your heart, pray this sinner's prayer with me right now. Heavenly Father, we thank you that we can see our need as a lost sinner. Lord, I did it on April the 4th, 1969. My dear wife and I were saved, 19310 Glenwood Lane, New Berlin, Wisconsin. And I'm thankful that same wonderful Savior, that conviction of the Holy Spirit that convicted us and brought us to a saving knowledge of Jesus Christ is available today. And I pray anyone watching this and via the Facebook or YouTube or other internet sources that they would say, Lord, be merciful to me, a sinner. Trust Christ. Follow the humble servant. Put their trust in his shed blood and his resurrection. And then we can be his humble spirit, his humble servants, and we can be used of God in a mighty way. Thankful for the truth of the Bible, the true greatness, true salvation, true godliness comes from humility. Help us to know it today. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, dear one, a little different today. We'll be talking with you tomorrow. We'll be in Sunday school is live, church is live. Sunday school on Eastern time. At 9, church at 10, church at 6 in the evening. God bless you. I hope you're in a good Bible-believing church, and if you're not or you're able to watch us at those times tomorrow, please tune in. God loves you. Have a good evening.